Hey everybody, welcome back to another adventure. We're here today at the Six Line Cemetery in Innisfil, and this is an old Scots cemetery that was established in the early 1830s by the Dalhousie settlers. And I just videoed, and I'll show it to you in the next bit, a beautiful cross that was erected at the front of the cemetery. It was erected by the descendants of those that are buried here in 1932, and it basically is positioned where the threshold of the original church and old kirk once stood. Now there's no church in the cemetery now other than a small memorial chapel which is used once a year, but the cemetery is quite fascinating. It would have been Presbyterian or Church of Scotland initially, but now it's interdenominational. There is a new part to the cemetery that is currently used, so we won't be going over there. So why don't we take a walk around some of the old graves? Hopefully we can get this video in before it starts raining. There were some shots I took yesterday, but I kind of got my butt handed to me by the mosquitoes and I had to leave. All right, so let's go take a look around the old tombstones here. So here's a shot of the old cemetery up on the hill here. Has some really fascinating monuments and headstones. There's also a lot that are not marked as well, which it's typical of this type of cemetery. Over to my left here is the modern day cemetery, or the cemetery that's used now, goes down, and there's the little memorial chapel there on the extreme left as well. That's used in June. Every second, I think it's the second weekend of June, they have their memorial service where people will come out and visit the graves of their ancestors and simply have a celebration. So let's walk up the hill and hopefully the mosquitoes aren't that bad, and take a look at some of the headstones that we've got here. I'm on the side of a hill here, so it makes it a little difficult to walk. But I want to take a look at this headstone here, this one. And looks like an eye, the very top of the headstone. And it's a memory of Hugh Farris. Oh, Farris, who died January 20th, 1881. 34 years of age, and then his wife, who died considerably sometime after him, she died in 1933. Then we have also a daughter who's named here. But you can see this is just a beautiful old headstone. Carefully here, coming up to some really old headstones. Here's some good ones. This is for the Reed family. This one is, well, I think that says Porter. Look at this one, beautiful. Here's another. Typical Victorian funerary art. And over here we have some judging by their size, their children. Yeah, it looks like a rose and a lamb. And what I'm seeing here is the last name of Wallace. So they look like brother and sister, died very young. 7 years of age and one. Now I believe there is a marked burial, and I'm going to try and find it, for some of the settlers. So let me take a look and I'll put you back on. So while I'm walking down the hill, I just came across the two headstones for Mary and John Coulter. I'm actually standing in the middle of the family plot. You can see the outline of it along the grass here. Again, that little wall that's, you can see it better over here. That ornamental wall that goes around the curb, I should say, not a wall. that goes around a family plot. And I think I found that other one I'm looking for, just over here. Here it is. Now you see we've got a bit of a sunken area, so I'll just have to be careful. This is actually the family plot of McConkie, Thomas and Sarah McConkie. And there's a plaque that was placed here in 1928, which is celebrating the 100th anniversary of their arrival in Innisfil. Here's the headstones for Thomas. And I'm pretty sure the one down there is for Sarah. It's unfortunately fallen over. It's a small family, just a double grave by the looks of things. And see if we can get a close-up here of the... I'm going to lean against Thomas here for a moment. I hope he doesn't mind. I would like to get a close-up. So there's the plaque that was erected by their descendants in 1928. It just says, to the honor and memory of Thomas and Sarah McConkie, who settled in Innisfil in 1828 and established the McConkie family in America. So this is the marker of one of the Dalhousie settlers here. This is John Lennox. He's a native of New Gumlock, Ayrshire, Scotland. He died in 1892, and I believe just behind here we've got a plaque, another cairn, erected in the memory of the Todd family. Here's their marker right here. And these were also... from the Dalhousie settlers, part of the Dalhousie settlers as well, that came here in 1831. And it says, to the memory of John and Elizabeth Todd and their sons, Hugh, Charles, Davidson, and Ebenezer, who came from Glasgow, Scotland, settled as pioneers in the township of Innisfil, along with the Dalhousie settlers from Lanark County, Ontario, in 1831, erected by their descendants in 1931. And over here, we have Davidson Todd's tombstone, little worn. I think it's, I can't make out that date. And there's an echo in here. Wow, quite the echo. I think it's because of all the gravestones, or something else is happening. Here's one of the cross. This is, I mentioned another Dalhousie settler. Notice the thistle on the top of the headstone. Good fellow. I believe they are also Dalhousie settlers. Died 1900. We got a beautiful stone here. This is Margaret, wife of John Goodfellow. Look at the thistle and the maple leaf there, depicting the homeland and the new world. She died at the age of 32 in 1861. and I may have to call this quits. I may have to call this quits, everybody, because it looks pretty damn ugly over to the west. We're supposed to be going to get some rain, even though this camera is supposed to be dust and rainproof. I don't know if I want to test it. I can feel it coming down. Anyway, I'll be mixing this video up with some of the video I took yesterday, so you'll see a lot more of the old headstones. I want to thank you for coming along with me here today. Remember, if you want to visit this place, do so with respect. Take only pictures, leave only footprints. All right? So until our next old cemetery adventure, this is Sharon saying bye-bye for now.